Hi, I'm John Smatlak. Welcome to another episode of Behind the Rails. Today we're here with Cal Cable number 43. This is a San Francisco cable car that operated in San Francisco until the 1950s when it came to Knott's Berry Farm here in Southern California. Walter Knott was a very famous collector of all kinds of interesting things, this particular cable car included. It was one of about five cars that were at Knott's Berry Farm and converted into battery-powered parking lot shuttles. There's a picture over here on the side of the car. You can see it operating. Basically, they removed the original grip mechanism, which grabbed the cable when it was a cable car, and they replaced it with a simple set of controls, some electric motors, and some air brakes, and batteries powered the motors, and it operated to carry visitors between the parking lot and other parts of the park. After the parking lot cable car shuttle operation was discontinued, four of the cars went back to San Francisco. This particular car stayed behind as a static display. The museum was able to get the car from Knott's Berry Farm in 1981, and we put it on display. Because it is 3'6" track gauge, it fits very nicely in with our Los Angeles City streetcar collection, and we're happy to be able to show it to folks here. It's one of our more popular displays. San Francisco's cable cars still operate today, and they're well worth a ride the next time you go to the Bay Area. San Francisco, of course, was not the only city in the United States with a cable car system. Cable car systems were in quite a number of U.S. cities, Los Angeles included. The cable cars were the replacement for the horse-drawn streetcar, and the electric car, in turn, replaced the cable car as a better and more efficient vehicle. Only in San Francisco, with the tremendous hills that they had to deal with, did the cable car survive, and thank goodness it did. Speaking of cable cars from San Francisco, here's car number 77. This is Sutter Street Railway cable car trailer number 77. It was built about 1890 by the Sutter Street Railway in San Francisco. It was built to the pattern of a horse car. It's pretty much identical to a horse car of the time. Trailer number 77 came to Knott's Berry Farm as well. Walter Knott collected this and used it as a food serving place. It's got that's why it has pretzels and lemonade on the letterboard. The interior of the car is quite original. It was pretty much unchanged at the park, and when we got it, it had a serving counter covering over the bench seats because, of course, they had been using it to serve refreshments. When it came to the museum, we removed the serving counter and were delighted to find the original bench seats were still intact. Obviously, the interior of the car is yet to be restored, but we're pleased that it has so much original fabric. The outside of the car, on the other hand, was pretty much built new at the park. They put new steel sides on it. They put a steel underframe underneath it, and we're hoping someday to use it as an operating horse car here at the Railway Museum. I'm John Smatlak. Thanks for joining us for another episode of Behind the Rails here at the Orange Empire Railway Museum. Check out the museum website for more videos and information about the museum, including how you can become a member and help us preserve Southern California's railway history. Thanks, and see you next time.
Hour on the trolley and lost my heart instead. With this light brown derby and this bright green tie, he was quite the handsomest of men. I started to yen, so I counted to 10, then I counted to 10 again.